Anyway, so the president wants to shame businesses into doing things his way. But small business owner Susan Tlovic and columnist Catherine Tim say that businesses would be better off if the president just got out of the way. Susan, why so?
Well, this shouldn't be any surprise to him, because before Obamacare was passed, businesses of all sizes, small and big companies, said, you know what, you do this, there are going to be a loss of jobs, and we're going to be sending people to the healthcare.gov so that they can get their subsidies and their health insurance. You know, I saw small businesses actually not growing because they got up to that 50-employee threshold, and they said, you know what, we're not going to grow. In a time when we needed to create jobs, and small businesses are the economic engine that creates jobs in this economy. So, but what Staples is doing is they are trying to save jobs, but they have had price pressures, they've had declining revenues ever since the recession hit, and they're not just raking it in.
They're going to be closing 200 unprofitable stores by the end of the year.
Right.
And they're merging with Office Depot. But taking them out of it, here, what I look at, Catherine, is this tendency to only vilify certain companies. If you're going to vilify them, you might as well vilify them all. Yet Apple, which is the darling of everyone's eye, I should disclose I'm a shareholder, they make these hot new gadgets, the iPhone 6 and 6 Plus. All of them are made in Asia. And those are jobs overseas, shifted overseas, benefits shifted overseas, it benefits at all. And they get a pass. Why is that?
Right. I love how they did not cite Obamacare, and he just jumped in so eagerly. Why are you talking about me? He obviously did want to talk about Staples, make them look bad. Maybe for the political reason, I don't know. But obviously, the government plays favorites in these kinds of deals. They always have. They always will. But it doesn't always
work. Only Staples had, you know, solar panels.
Right. It doesn't always work out the way you want to, though, because what they seem to forget is with anything, businesses have the freedom to respond to offset costs or transfer costs in whatever way that they see fit. And they have to do that, because you can't just pass a law and force someone to be able to.
And I agree with you. I think that is a factor. And I know Staples came out with statements saying that the percentage of part-time workers is what it was long before the law. That might be the case, but I do think this is an impetus. But I'm wondering here, when I went to Staples and started doing a little research, they do offer part-time workers all these benefits, maybe not as generous as the president wants, maybe not as many as they want, or down to same-sex benefits after 60 days of work. It is a very, as far as company policies go, pretty generous policy.
Well, and actually, they offered to their part-time employees health care coverage,
That's
too.
Right.
But it didn't meet the minimum.
It didn't meet that.
Right.
That was key.
So what is better, you know, to have some coverage versus nothing? It makes no sense.
You almost hadn't figured the president making that remark that they don't do squat for their workers, when in fact they did.
Yeah.
Right.
And, you know, I also think that, you know, it's important to point out here that the president was really interjecting his own business philosophy with Obamacare. He's reached into our businesses and said, this is the way you are going to do it. And you know what? This is a free country. We have free enterprise and capitalism. And it's fine for a business owner to sit back and say, no, Mr. President, you're
well,
not going to dictate.
Well, what's not fine, Catherine, is that you're making a big profit, and I think you should be spending that profit on this, right? It's preaching.
Oh, yeah. Right, except for, like you mentioned, Staples isn't doing all that well right now, having to close all these stores. I don't even know about the Internet. People can buy tons of paper clips online without having to get up off their couch for a lot less money. So sorry.
And but free shipping.
Free shipping.
That's
yeah,
right.
Exactly.
That's
all
right.
Kinds of options that the market will invent. And meanwhile, well, you're
he doesn't know about
regulations.
Market forces. He doesn't know about business, doesn't care about business.
Clearly.
And he just thinks
it's
very
the same with community college things, too, because if he said it was free tuition and that actually
right.
worked.
Right.
You could, the schools can just raise the fees. You can always something you can do to get around it. And whether he likes it or not, that's how it works.
I don't know, ladies, but that was not easy. Anyway, Fox Biz Alert here. President Obama formally asking Congress to approve a war on ISIS.